5 सेकेंड, 2 सेकेंड, रेडी। सो फार एज द फाइलिंग ऑफ कंप्लेंट डायरेक्टली बिफोर द कमीशन बिकॉज ऑफ हायर वैल्यूशन द प्रोसीडर्स लेड डाउन इन रूल 14 ऑफ द रूल्स हैव टू बी फॉलोड एंड इन दैट केस द नेम ऑफ द अपोजिट पार्टी हैज टू बी गिवेन सो फार दे कैन बी असर्टेन्ड। In the present case, the appellant filed original petition impleading the institute where her husband was admitted as a party, but she did not implead the treating doctors and nurses who were attending on her husband. Though the commission directed that necessary parties may be impleaded, and it appears that no effort was made to implead the treating surgeon or the nursing staff as a party. Therefore, the question is whether non-impleading the treating surgeon or a nursing staff can be said to be necessary party, and if they are not impleaded, then in that case the original petition can result into dismissal on account of non-joinder of necessary party. So far as the law with regard to the non-joinder of necessary party under Code of Civil Procedure, Order 1st Rule 9 and Order 1st Rule 10 of the CPC, there also even no suit shall fail because of misjoinder or non-joinder of parties. It can proceed against the persons who are parties before the court. Even the court has the power under Order 1, Rule 10 to give direction to implead a person who is a necessary party. Therefore, even if after the direction given by the commission, the concerned doctor and the nursing staff who were looking after the deceased A.K. Garg have not been impleaded as opposite parties, it cannot result in dismissal of the original petition as a whole. The consumer forum is primarily meant to provide better protection in the interest of the consumers and not to short circuit the matter or to defeat the claim on technical grounds. Reverting back to the facts of the present case, whether non-joinder of the treating doctor, nursing staff can result into dismissal of the claim petition. As a matter of fact, when a patient is admitted to the highly commercial hospital like the present institute, a thorough check-up of the patient is done by the hospital authorities. It is the institute which selects after the examination of the patient that he suffers from what malady and who is the best doctor who can attend, except when the patient or the family members desire to be treated by a particular doctor or the surgeon, as the case may be. Normally, the private hospitals have a panel of doctors in various specialties, and it is they who choose who is to be called. It is very difficult for the patient to give any detail that which doctor treated the patient and whether the doctor was negligent or the nursing staff was negligent. It is very difficult for such patient or his relatives to implead them as parties in the claim petition.